Auto-sync failed in Resolve? Yeah, me too. Well, what if you didn't have to ask anyone to clap? Or you could freely stop and then start recording as much as you'd like, and never worry about capturing quality scratch audio for syncing up multiple cameras with external audio recorders. Well, actually, you can, by syncing with timecode. And if you edit videos with DaVinci Resolve like I do, I'm gonna come alongside you today and show you some of my timecode syncing tricks you've never seen before, like adjusting source timecode on import, and then tweaking that audio offset column on the media page to get perfect sync for clips even long after they've been cut on a timeline. And that doesn't even touch the most significant superpower that Final Cut Pro and Premiere never had, or maybe ever will. Plus, I've got a bonus improved multicam, multi-channel, polywave audio tip that you're not gonna wanna miss at the end. So, the problem is that after a shoot, we end up with this big pile of SD cards and footage that we've got to make sense of, right? Multiple cameras, a separate audio recorder, and then the fastest way to organize them and sort them and group them is based on the time code that was actually recorded during production. We're gonna fix it in camera, right? Now, I've been syncing sound professionally for about 20 years now, so if anyone knows, I understand that waveform syncing is great, but you already know that it doesn't always work as you'd hope for in Resolve. And if you sync by timecode, you remove the limitation for a camera to be like right next to the audio recorder or sound source, because now sound doesn't actually matter on the camera anymore. What is timecode actually? Now, I got this wrong for a long time, so let me clarify what timecode is. Timecode, it's just a number to track time down to the individual frame, right? A number to track time to the frame. If you jam sync, and that's a fun word to say, jam sync, then the jam sync timecode sets each device's to a start with the same frame number. That's the key that I missed for several years. When they start together. If you always need them to be locked together over time, that's gen lock and word clock, and it's outside of the world of filmmaking that we all love. It's more of like a live production system. So that does mean that we will inherently drift over long recordings because each device is writing down data to frames on its own oscillator, which can actually change with the temperature. Now, that's enough science. And that's actually why this amazing device from Deity called the TC1 solves this problem. The TC1 has a temperature-compensated crystal oscillator that can hold time much longer and more accurately than anything built into, like, any camera. I mean, any camera. So when you feed a reliable timecode clock to each device, you get reliably consistent start times. All that to say is that it makes starting to edit this big pile of multicam footage or dual system sound fast and easy. The big picture of this timecode workflow goes like this. Oh, and I chapter mark all the content here on Creative Video Tips, so jump to that specific moment that you need to reference. It's there for you. I'm Chadwick, and I'm actually here for you. Now, step one, each device, each camera is gonna get its own generator that has a timecode clock that's in sync. So if you've got three cameras, you're gonna use three generators. To help with this video, Aperture actually sent me these devices, but you really wanna keep them connected all the time. Two, we have slaves and we have a master. It sounds archaic, but those are the terms. The master is the master, and then the slaves get their timecode from the master. Simple, right? Ideally, you use the time of day, like in real time, which is handy if a producer makes a note of something that maybe cool happened at 10 a.m. Then it's simple to find in your bin and Resolve just by sorting the bin column. Now, the Deity timecode generators can output this timecode as either an audio signal that you can hear, it sounds kind of awful like this, or it can output the timecode as metadata, which is one of these rolling numbers that I'm sure you've seen. They'll eventually both just be used as a number. I'm gonna show you both ways, and the advantage of using the metadata output is that it skips a conversion step, and that frees up your camera's mic input. But not all cameras have timecode metadata input, so the audio output solves this problem. Three, you go out and you do your thing. You film all day long without worry. You turn the camera off and on when you recompose your shots. You don't have to worry about having tons of clips to sync afterwards, and you can save space on video storage by not filming a whole bunch of garbage. And then four, in DaVinci Resolve, we're gonna auto-sync a whole batch with the timecode metadata instantly. The Citus audio app can be managed and synchronized over Bluetooth to your iPhone, but why my favorite timecode generator is this Deity is because I can see everything on it without using my phone, since it actually has a screen on it. Check it out. It seems obvious, right, Tentacle? Anyways, another amazing thing is they actually include a breakout charging cable for USB that has all three TC1s getting connected from one USB-A port. That's just brilliant. Now, the one thing that I wish they would include is one or two more of the 3.5 millimeter audio cables, because you do get other cables, but I need more, just the plain ones. The good thing is that they're cheap, and I just used some I had from Tentacle, and any stereo cable is going to work. Now, Deity, they're also listening all the time, and recently they had a firmware update to add 2398 support for slaving my TC1s from my Mix Pre, and the update was simple to download and install using the iPhone app. Now, there's already a bunch of great tutorials out there on how the app works with Bluetooth, so what I'm going to show you today is how I actually use my Sound Devices Mix Pre as a master clock, which, by the way, doesn't need its own TC1 as long as it's a Series 2 unit, because they have a real crystal clock internally, and then jam sync the Deity TC1s, all three of these, as slaves. If you're considering buying one of these Deity TC1s or any cables, I've got links down below, and they help support my family anytime you click on them. We're gonna first choose time code on the Mix Pre, frame rate 2398, TC mode to free run. Side note here, you want to match the frame rate on your cameras, and most cameras shoot the non-integer rates, like 23.98, even when they say 24 or 30. They don't actually mean it. I'm looking at you, Sony. Choose outputs, stereo out mode, LTC out. Now plug a 3.5 millimeter cable into the Mix Pre stereo out, change the TC1 to receive line in, connect the cable, and boom, we've got matching time code, basically. Now unplug the TC1 and change it to L out or A out, depending on if your camera is going to take audio or metadata time code. A is for audio time code, and lock for safety. Now, if you get stuck and you need to make changes, you triple tap the main button to unlock. So here's the camera setups I have going on. The Sony FX3 as metadata time code, change the TC to preset and free run, and use a Deity TC3 cable or the VMC BNC M1 from Sony with a BNC to 3.5 millimeter cable to plug it into the USB multiport. You should see the EXT timecode change. Now for the Sony A7IV's audio timecode, just make sure the TC1 is set to output audio timecode. You plug it into the mic jack, maybe lower the volume a little bit from the default of 26, and you're good. For the BMPCC 4K, the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K, that's always a mouthful to say, ensure that the TC1 is set to L for the L output, that's linear timecode. But in this case, we're actually going to still put it into the mic jack. And even though it's going into the mic jack, it's going to take linear time code, the metadata time code from the Deity box. It's not going to use that audio, awful audio time code that you have to convert. Now you can freely record your video, stop and start cameras as needed. I like to keep the audio recorder rolling for long takes because sometimes there's sound that is kind of unexpected. And then you can actually still use that to edit into your video with some B-roll. Oh. And if you're learning anything new today, please like this video so more creatives like you can see and learn this stuff too. In general, you can just drag your clips right into DaVinci Resolve and put them in a bin.
Oh, and when you drag from Finder into Resolve, if you do it to the left side, you'll actually maintain your bins from the Finder, and you can access all of them at once still by just shift selecting them. But here's three quick tips to fix any timecode differences you might see in Resolve.
Now, if you use the same camera and setup all the time, and you know there's a difference between the audio recorder and the camera timecode sync, you can actually change how Resolve sees the timecode when you import it to fix this difference.
My Sony FX3 and Blackmagic cameras both seem to need a -1 or -2 to match up with the Sound Devices Mix Pre. None of these steps actually change the actual timecode of the files, which is important to know. That means if a system outside of Resolve needs to link to them for finishing, this is not the ideal workflow. But this is great if you do all of your post-production inside of Resolve, because we're changing Resolve-only metadata.
To add them with offset, you do this from the media storage area by right-clicking and saying add to media pool with offset. And then for this, I'm going to choose -2, apply, and it has modified Resolve-only metadata. I'm going to do the same thing with the B-Raw clips over here. Add in a media pool with offset. I'm going to change this to -2. And apply.
This would be for video files with linear timecode only. So to recap, I use about -1, -2 on the cameras that I've got. Your mileage is gonna vary. And then to sync them, you just select them again, you right click and say auto sync audio based on timecode. You can append if you want, just to add the new audio. It's all just metadata though, and it's completely non-destructive. Update timecode from audio track converts that audio signal timecode on my cameras, like the Sony a7 IV, or really any camera with a mic input, into usable metadata timecode inside of Resolve. It's as simple as right-clicking, just like so much else in this tutorial, and you choose to update the timecode from audio track. And boom, you'll see the timecode values change right away. The A7 IV timecode matches very closely to my audio recorder master timecode, but you can see it doesn't match exactly if I step through here. See, it's a little bit late. However, you can change this value after you converted it by right-clicking and choosing Clip Attributes, going to the Timecode tab over here and choosing +1 frame works for the A7 IV. We click OK. And then we sync it again. We can say right click and choose auto sync audio based on timecode. And let's check out the sync now. Perfect.
So yeah, that's even another way to modify timecode in Resolve. Finally, use the audio offset column for perfection. This isn't a timecode exclusive trick, it's just an audio sync tip. It's even gonna fix sync for clips that are already on a timeline. Start by showing full clip audio waveforms in the viewer on the media page. This is under the three-dot menu, show full clip audio waveform. If you have a visual cue, like a clap, you can go directly to that frame to see how close the sync is. I actually also have a very famous B and P trick that I teach in this tutorial that's gonna be super helpful if you don't have timecode or audio waveforms to sync against. So after you've auto-synced or manually synced dual system audio from an external recorder, you can open up this audio offset column just by right-clicking and checking the box. Let's also choose the angle column to be visible for a later step in this tutorial. Back to the audio offset column. In this case, I did not use the import offset, so you can see we're about 2 frames out of sync if I step through. So to fix it, I can just select the audio offset column and change this value directly right in here. So -2 from here would put us at about 312.7. We can check it again here in the viewer. And we have perfect sync.
You can get very granular with this for extreme precision. Now is actually the best time to create proxies, not before. Proxies make it easy to play back footage on any computer and can sometimes make smaller files that make the originals a lot easier to send over the internet. First, set the proxy settings you want to use. Go to the project settings, that's the gear icon in the lower right, master settings, and change your proxy media resolution right here. In general, I choose half-res ProRes proxy. This makes a 1080p file from a 4K source, and it's gonna play on a 10-year-old computer easily. Now, if you're on Windows, choose DNxHRLB for a really similar file. To make the proxies, you just select them in the media pool, you right-click, you guessed it, and choose Generate Proxy Media. The reason we waited until now to create the proxies is that we're actually gonna get our linked external synced audio included in the files with our updated timecode. On the other hand, the external proxy generator app, that's actually great for several reasons, but is not what you wanna use when you need to customize your settings and also include that high quality audio.
Now, when your proxies are done, you can check to make sure that they're actually created by opening the column layout for proxy and proxy media path. That'll let you know they're there. And then to actually use them, you go to the playback menu, proxy handling, prefer proxies.
Prior to creating the multicam, I like to assign angle metadata to each camera to help place clips from the same camera on the same multicam tracks. That way they're not stacked all super tall. Batch select clips from the same camera by shift selecting them. Open the metadata panel in the upper right and change the view to all groups. And now change the angle to 1, 2, 3, etc. But don't forget to hit the save button at the bottom, and this is gonna apply that same angle to all of them at once.
Rinse and repeat applying angles to all of the camera clips, but don't forget about the audio, which I wanna also include in our multicam clip. So we're gonna assign angle 4 to that,
And since it's one single clip, it's saved automatically. Now, to create the multicam with your timecode synced clips, it's easy. You just right click, you choose create new multicam clip using selected clips. You change the angle sync to timecode, angle name to metadata angle, and detect clips from the same camera with the option for metadata angle as well. Now, I personally uncheck the box for move source clips to original clips bin because, well, I'm kind of a control freak and I like to organize things myself. Maybe you can relate.
Hit create, and then you can right click on the multicam clip to open in timeline just to check to make sure everything worked out.
I'll link to tutorials on editing multicam, but here's a bonus tip that I've picked up since teaching about multi-channel multicam in Resolve that's gonna save you time. Resolve multicam clips, they kind of like to create adaptive audio tracks, which is kind of like, it's like a mix down of all the audio channels. So the way I like to get access to all those individual channels from that mixdown on the edit page is just to get them when I need them by doing this little trick. With the multicam viewer open, change the sound to the audio angle that's got the good sound. That's obvious, right? Even though it's still a mixdown adaptive track. We're gonna fix that right now, okay?
Option click just the source audio and then go up to the viewer and then choose source there as well. And go up under the clip menu.
And now we're gonna use match frame to source clip with this audio selected. This is gonna take you directly to the Polywave multi-channel source, and then you can simply do an overwrite edit back onto the timeline. So it's a match frame to source clip, and then an overwrite edit. Match frame source clip, overwrite edit. Match frame to source clip is different from the normal match frame, which matches the frame that's on the timeline up into the source monitor. This actually goes a bit deeper, and it's why you can actually get to the source audio very quickly. To overwrite edit, you can just hit F10 on the keyboard or just drag to the right monitor and see the pop-up for overwrite, then you just release. Oh, and you can also batch change your audio track types to mono using the edit index panel that's up here. Just click on the tracks, shift select the tracks, and finally right click to make the format to mono. Hey, I'm Chadwick. I'm here to help you create videos that make a difference and stand out. If I was able to like teach you anything new today, please let me know down in the comments what that new thing was. That helps out a lot. I really appreciate all the feedback. And if you're new to editing multicam, check out this video next. And because there's so much more to learn, I'll see you in the next video.